Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel. Longer video today because there's tons of news. But before I start, this is the US code for Honor and Duty D-Day. We're gonna talk about this game in a minute, but congratulations to whoever won. Very, very good online shooter. I went yesterday to just check out the update and spending it few hours and enjoyed it. If you won, please let us know in comment section so we can know and congratulate you. And if you like what you've seen and if you're new to the channel, then please press a like button and also subscribe, because it's always better when it's more of us. Let's make it bigger, let's make it better. And now let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. We're gonna start from Sony's announcement, because they announced today that they gonna do new video series on their channel, which gonna be called State of Play. And this series will be featuring updates and announcements from the world of PlayStation. They're gonna update us on PS4 games, but also PSVR games, and there might be few announcements. First episode will air on March 25th at 2 PM PT. PT of course stands for Pitiful Tortillas. Or 5 PM ET. ET of course stands for Energetic Titties. They said there's gonna be new trailers, new game announcements, new gameplay footage. It's gonna be held across YouTube, Twitch, Facebook and Twitter. So this year was quiet for the announcements. We recently just like secretly found out rumored release date for Blood and Truth. Also Everybody's Golf got rated in Australia, but you know, from Sony they didn't really told us much. It's like quietness to the point of not hearing anything. So I'm assuming maybe it's quiet before the storm. I think this series might give us some very, very good and very anticipated updates. Make sure you tuned in on 25th. Okay, next story. And we're gonna talk about Golem, a long, long awaited game, kind of everyone taking peace out of it, that it might even not happen, forever delayed, but there is progress, there is a bit of movement, because the developers said that the game will be playable at PAX East next week. So they've got demo working, there was old demo, I'm assuming this gonna be new demo, and maybe at PAX they gonna give us release date as well. This game was delayed, but I always say it's better wait and have better game than not wait, have rushed game, and then everyone be like, oh fuck this game, it's shit, nobody likes it, blah 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 blah, me. We don't want that, we want proper good game, and I think that's what we gonna get, because this team work on it for a very long time to our disappointment, but when it's released, I'm sure it's gonna get our approval. Okay, next story. And why don't we talk a bit about Conrad the Kitten, one of the biggest PSVR games and VR games that ever released. Such a game, graphics, everything just cut. Amazing. Everybody bought this game. Yes, if you bought it, please let us know in comment section. It would be nice to see at least two people. But anyway, what's happening? They doing 2.0 update. I spoke about it in past, but this pussy is about to get a lot better, because there will be graphic update, some new mechanics, and also there won't be out of energy come back tomorrow mechanic, which game basically been telling you, right, that's your time up, go on, fuck off, don't play anymore, come back tomorrow. This won't happen, because people was getting annoyed with it, rightfully so. So Conrad the Kitten, it's not only gonna look better, but also it's gonna play better. Now this is proper hyped for this game. Conrad the Kitten, wow. Okay, next story. And it's time to talk about Operation Warcade, a game that I like very, very much. Great game with pretty terrible graphics, but nevertheless, gameplay-wise, amazing. Graphically, it was okay, like Dreamcast game, maybe from this area. The developers released update, and this update brings us 3D Rudder support. I'm assuming it's for the vehicle sections of the game, which is not really that many of them. But also, they said they bring PS4 Pro support, so I went and checked it out, but don't get too excited. Graphically, it looks exactly the same, which is jaggy, and anything what they added is just objects appearing. They got like a effect to them, like blah, 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 and they hear like a matrix. You're like, wow, is that all? And that is all. Also, they updated 3D sound and the sound actually got worse. You cannot hear the goon, so this needs to be addressed. I love Operation Warcade, but I did expect more from this patch because graphics pretty much didn't change. And also, I cannot locate the little cabinet with 2D version of Operation Warcade. We've got 2 cabinets in past, now it's only one, I don't know, maybe I'm doing something wrong, but still very, very good game. Now, next story, and we're gonna talk about Honor and Duty D-Day. I just don't give away for it, just at the beginning of this video. But now I want to talk about it because the game got new update and it's free for all mode, which basically means, you know, free for all. I don't have to explain it. But what I want to talk about is what they're gonna bring in the future. Because they hard at work on adding the planes to the game so you'll be able to fly, it's even gonna support Thrustmaster, well, any HOTAS out there it will be supported, so nice. This game pretty much supports every single controller. But apart from planes, we should get very, very soon, it's just around the corner. Just wait a bit longer. It's gonna be a trial mode, like a demo mode. Basically, it's gonna be free-to-play mode. And this mode will have Battle Royale in it. So anyone be able to download the game and you're not gonna have anything, but you're gonna have Battle Royale and you'll be able to play it for free. This developer is awesome. And also don't forget, I mentioned the other day, they're gonna remaster Honor and Duty Arcade Edition as well. Because they just like to be hard at work all the time. They thinking, time to go to bed and rest. And then they brain says, rest? What's that? Let's make some more shit for those people who own PSVR because we are so awesome. Okay, and now next story. In the background for you plays the game called Helicopter. A virtual reality experience. That's the name of it. So do I have to explain anything? Very self-explanatory name of the game. Yes, it is, because it's about the helicopter. The developer of this game took to Reddit today because he said, right, it's out already on PC, I released it, but now I'm working on PSVR version, so I need some advice. Because so far this game, you're just flying around in helicopter, you like on the ground, looking somewhere around and seeing your chopper, and you like, I need to play with this baby. So you're walking inside it and you're saying, okay, let's go, and you're flying around, and that's all what you're doing. But for PSVR version, the devs said they want to make very high intense combat in VR helicopter, destruction of the enemy base, commander missions, stories, and possibility on multiplayer also. So it looks like when it comes to PSVR gonna be bigger game, looks like it's coming from just one dude, I suppose, so it's not the easiest thing to make, but still, this person making it, people been commenting in comment section that they want to be it like Airwolf. That's the comment with the most of like our likes. So maybe we gonna get some sort of Airwolf game. Helicopters on PSVR are very, very missed because there is none of them. And flying games wise as well, there's not many of them at all. Of course, I spoke just few minutes ago. That's how fresh this video is. Just few minutes I spoke about planes in Honor and Duty, but also we've got Ace Combat, we've got Flying Aces upcoming, but not really much. And of course, amazing Ultra Wings. But apart from that, that's about it. So to have this helicopter game, this is definitely happy news for anyone. So good luck to the developer, I know you only like one person, so it's hard undertaking, but we appreciate it. Okay, next story. And we're gonna talk a bit about Vertigo Home. Yes, this game still exists, it's a lot of people liking it, a trippy tunnel game, but what people complained a bit, it was that they can control game without remote, but to restart they have to press X on remote, and it was very inconvenient. Beautiful English on this channel. But anyway, developers listened to feedback and said, okay, we changed it. Now you can restart the game just with your head. No need for remote at all. And also there is some audio options now as well, so more options in the game. Okay, and next story, just quick coming back to Trover Saves the Universe, because we was thinking this gonna be PSVR and PS4 exclusive, but that's not the case anymore. So if you own PC VR and you wanted to play this game, yes, it's coming as well. I know a lot of people like to have your PlayStation exclusive because it gives you these justifications. We might have shit controllers, but we got amazing exclusives. But this is not first party. Sony's first party exclusives are awesome, and I think for smaller indie studios, well, I don't know, Trover Saves the Universe studio seems to be doing well, But anyway, it's better for the games to be released everywhere, because then more people buy it and the developers earn more money to make us some more games. And now let's talk about Ace Combat 7. What a game, especially on PlayStation VR. The VR missions are amazing. Bandai Namco currently doing a survey, which I gonna link in the description, which asks you some questions, what would you change in the game, what you would ask, you know, your typical survey stuff. But also there is one question which tells you what you enjoy the most about the game. So of course, me being a PSVR dude, I put that the VR mode was the best for me. And also they've got some comments what you can add at the end, so I said, listen. VR mode is awesome, VR missions are beautiful, they play great, but there is only three of them, which is definitely not enough, and I would be more than happy to play some more. So if you want to fill this survey, feel free, link in the description, you can let them know if you want to have more VR mode, because that's, I'm assuming, what we want. Those VR missions are amazing, but there is not enough. Okay, time to breathe, and that's it, bye.